number.
Goodbye, my public.
It cut nothing. Go back and finish the act or no pay. Music!
Hey, look, wait a minute.
Can't win. Let's give the old goat what he wants.
Sweetheart, here's a little proposition that I've been wishing I could reveal. If you'll only help me concentrate now, I'll try to relate how I feel. Here are you, and here am I. No moon in view, no star on high, but it's a lovely night to spend. Let's pretend there's a moon. Nights like this were made for love, regardless of the moon above. The time and place are opportune. Oh, let's pretend there's a moon. Oh, it's like to tell about the spell of moonlight blue.
And they weave it into every rhyme.
Now we don't need the moon above to tell us when to kiss.
So why should we be wasting time? Here are we, love, and here is love. Who cares if there's no moon above? Let's make believe the one that's true.
Be asking too much and want to know what this is for?
Your salary for the week.
Oh, but my good man, it's just a slight mistake. This is only half of it. Come, come, come.
Go ahead, sue me.
Oh, now, wait a minute, Chisler. You're not going to get away with this.
There was no money. You saw the business. I'm splitting what there was between the acts. That's yours.
You mean to tell me we work 5 shows a day for 7 days and get paid off an old used earmuffs?
Well, you're lucky. I've been in this business 20 years and I haven't got even that. Tomorrow morning, it's either bankruptcy or I shoot myself.
Oh, yeah? Well, do me a favor and forget the bankruptcy, will you?
Mother told me there'd be nights like this.
You should have believed it and stayed home in Little Rock.
Doesn't matter. Meals weren't regular.
How about the dough situation? By the time we get 2 paying a room rent, we won't have enough left for the rattler back to the big town.
It looks like the old routine, tossed the bags out the window.
You saw that landlady, didn't you? She knows we're closing tonight. She's seen actors before.
Anyway, that old suitcase of mine won't stand one more toss on the first floor, much less the third.
Okay, Mastermind, what do we do now? Don't worry about a thing. I'll think of something. Just give me time.
I've gotten awfully hungry waiting for you before.
Wait a minute.
There you are, boys and girls.
Maybe I'm nearsighted, but I just don't see my name there anywhere.
I mean, that's where we belong.
Oh, come on.
Are we going to raise enough dough to get home?
We'll go send some wires. Maybe we find somebody silly enough to send it. There you are.
Have you got a message for Charlie Sullivan?
Sullivan?
Uh-huh.
Here we are.
Whee!
For once you've made it. Come on, let's have it.
Collect, Mr. Sullivan, 55 cents.
Collect? That's funny. There must be some mistake.
55 cents?
Well, 50 bucks ought to be worth 55 cents. Scotty, let me have 55 cents.
Let him have 55 cents.
I owe you 55 cents.
I shall repeat the paid telegram to the Earl Craft offices, Earl Craft Theater Building, New York City. Have received no answer to my wire of last night about Harold Seabrook. Stop. If he is not down here today, we'll come up there myself and fire every... Sorry, Mr. Craft, I can't send anything like that over the wire.
All right, make it good. Every single one of you. Stop. I can't stand this Hammond of the day. He's awful. Signed, Earl Craft.
Right. Thank you.
Well, I wonder what your high-pressure boyfriend is up to now.
Oh, don't be too hard on him. One of his ideas might work out someday and surprise you.
Hello, Western Union? This is Earl Craft of the Apollo Theater again. Yeah, just gave you a wire. Right, I want to cancel it. Yeah, take this one instead. Uh-huh, to the same address.
I shall repeat your paid message. Hold Seabrook. Pay no attention to previous wires. Have filled pause satisfactorily. Signed, Earl Craft.
This time I got it sure. Come on, let's go.
Where to now?
The Apollo Theater.
What are we going to do? Hand-to-hand balancing in the lobby?
We'll skip the gags, dearie. I just got Scotty a job at the 9 o'clock frolic. Come on. Yesterday and rushed us right down here. Of course, we had to cancel the rest of the week to make it, but we figured a chance in one of your shows was worth it. And anyway, everybody knows Seabrook's reputation. He's a souse from the word go. On your opening night, he's just as liable to fall flat in his face.
Yeah, I know all about it, but I had to take a chance on the comedy voice. What's this guy's name?
Scotty.
I never heard of him. Who are you?
Charlie Sullivan, his manager.
I never heard of you either.
Well, that makes us even. There was a time nobody ever heard of you.
All right, put him on. But I warn you, if he can't sing, I'm going to twist your neck until it looks like a spiral staircase.
Now, Mr. Craft, calm yourself. Remember, you're a badly overworked man. You're only going to upset yourself again.
Let's have it.
Go on up there, you mug, and sing like you never sang before. Toby, play for him. One wrong note, and I'll throw the piano at you. Go on. Now, remember, it's do or die for dear old Putnam Hall.
Clear the stage. Sit down, everybody.
Where do you hear this kid, Mr. Craft? Is the answer to your prayers?
Music is the language heaven sent from above. There is nothing half so grand understood in every land. You are all my music. You're my one song of love. It begins and ends with you, dear. It's you I hear. You're like a lover's dream in the spring, a song of the trees and the birds. I don't know how to say it, too beautiful for words. like a sweet refrain that will cling, a strain that the angels prefer. All I can do is play.
Come on, be quiet.
Too beautiful for words, like the music of a Berlin or a Gershwin, or even a moonlight serenade. Though I can compare with Berlin or with Gershwin, to me you'll always be a perfect rhapsody for you. Bring an inspiration to sing a song that can never be heard. You're just a lovely lost soul, too beautiful for
glad to know you. Talked to you just a few minutes ago. I'm Sullivan, Mr. Kraft's assistant.
Oh, how do you do? Won't you come in?
You can skip that. I am in. Just wanted to make sure you were comfortable.
Anything I can do? No, no, I don't think so.
I'm also appointed as entertainment committee of one. Now, what can you suggest?
Entertainment committee? Oh, pardon me, sir. Just a slight headache. I've been reading a good deal lately.
Yes, yes, yes. Nothing like a good book. Now about the entertainment. You see, there's no rehearsal until tomorrow night. Mr. Kraft thought you might get a little lonesome.
I thought you were opening in 3 days.
Oh, we had to put the date back. Couldn't get ready.
Oh. Oh, that's fine.
Yeah, I thought you'd think so. Well, how about? Like to go out and look around and get some air?
No, I scarcely think
that. Tut, tut, tut. Not another word. I got a better idea. Suppose I get downstairs, get a bottle. We have a couple of little nips. Nothing like a couple of little nips, you know, to help you make up your mind. But if I go too fast, now stop me. Maybe you don't drink.
Oh, well, I take one now and then. As a matter of fact, I believe I have a bottle somewhere with me. Just in case of a cold or something, you
certainly
know.
Certainly.
I'll go look in my bag.
Don't bother. It's right in back of you.
Charlie, you've always admired me, haven't you, old boy?
Why, of course, Brookie.
Where are we going?
Just for a little trip.
I think I'll get a little sleep.
Okay, Brookie, old pal, you do that.
Paul. How things?
Well, where have you been?
Out for a ride. I'd have been back a long time ago if something happened to the car and I had to stop and get it fixed.
Hey, you! Is there a guy named Charlie Sullivan around here?
How dare you interfere with my rehearsal like this? Who are you?
We're from the police. We want to know if there's a Charlie Sullivan here.
Oh, so it's you, Seabrook.
Yes, it's me.
Well, what's the idea? What's the riot for?
Well, I've been the victim of an outrage. We want this guy, Sullivan.
What for?
Kidnapping and stealing an automobile, that's all.
Oh, why didn't I think of that? What have you done?
What is it?
I can't stop for questions. I'll see you around sometime, folks.
Where are you going?
To the Canary Islands, if I can make it.
All over
there. Will you let go?
Another chance.
No, listen, this is my rap. You sat here with Cramp, and this is your chance. You're sticking here.
Don't be a chump. Get along, little doggies. Get along. Sullivan, is there any way to keep you from doing these things?
How did I know it was going to turn out that way?
You didn't have to steal his car to top it off.
I wasn't going to walk back from where I left him.
Oh, Charlie, you should.
Oh, let's forget it. You were trying for all of us. We know that.
It sure was great while it lasted.
Don't worry. I'll think of something. I'll get you out of this.
Out of this? Not me, you won't. It's the first place I've been sure of in weeks.
I second the motion.
Well, if you gentlemen will pardon me, I'm going to run upstairs and get some sleep.
If you go through the east wing, you'll find the Rose Room all ready for you.
Try and get some sleep, honey. I'm sorry I messed things up.
Oh, I think nothing of it. I see a great big chair way in the back. Sleep well, Kitty.
Here's a gal for you.
She sure is.
You know, it's the way she takes things that makes me feel the worst. If she'd only squawk once in a while.
You've got it pretty bad, haven't you?
You're asking me?
Well, I figured that when she first joined you. What are you planning to do about it?
Why do you think I'd almost lie, steal, or commit arson? Just so I can do something about her. Well, I'm finally broken down.
It's never been exactly a secret to me, anyway.
There's no use talking about it. You know, I got a hunch New York's gonna be a pretty hot place for little Charlie. Those cops weren't kidding.
You hear what I hear? Get back in there. Maybe it's an ambulance or something.
I got a feeling this is me.
Gendarmes.
Hello over there!
This is the end. They got me.
You just went by a main highway intersection at 40 miles an hour. And you're getting a ticket.
Catch me, I'm gonna faint.
If you do, it'll be on top of me, because I'm doing it right now.
Me first, and we'll faint three high. Anything doing? Well, I'm gonna hit two officers and then quit. They're asking too many questions.
What do you mean?
Everybody wants to know if you're the Charlie Sullivan that was in Atlantic City lately.
Oh, they got the dragnet out for me.
From what I've seen, I'd say they have.
I knew it. I gotta get out of town.
Just exactly how are we going to arrange that?
We has nothing to do with it. I pulled this. You're not in on it.
I want to get sore at you pretty soon if you don't quit this. If any getting out of town, we'll do it together. How much longer is this, dump good for?
Oh, yeah, I forgot to tell you. Our charming landlady was up again today.
What's the bad news?
3 days more to pay or oomph.
She's got a heart like a rock.
And the rock's a sponge compared to hers.
Come in.
Well.
Meet your new boarder.
Not for long. We're only playing 3 days here.
Well, that's nothing. My old pal here turned out to be good for one more throw.
Well, here you are, and it's all yours.
I think I'll sleep for the next 3 days and get ready. I never could rest on a park bench.
Now, look, don't you worry about that.
No, no, don't worry about a thing. Everything's going to be just dandy.
Don't be so upset. We've been broke before.
That's not all. The cops are after me.
How do you know?
Every office Scotty went into, they asked about me.
Well, where, when, and how do we go?
Are you sticking to?
I might as well starve in company. Anyhow, I like to travel.
You know something? You're the grandest thing that was ever invented.
I'd like to be an invention that worked.
We'll get out of this and everything will be all right. You wait and see.
I'm so broken into hard luck now that I wouldn't know what to do if something good did happen.
I'll make it happen. Gee, I hate to see you in a spot like this.
I'll endorse that.
I want you to have things, everything, be comfortable and not have to worry.
That's sweet of you, but I doubt if my heart could stand a shock like that.
I'll get them for you. You wait and see.
Well, let's figure on something immediate instead, like how to get dinner tonight.
Oh, why do you always clown when I get on a level with you?
I'm not, darling, but this is hardly the time for the personal note.
Has the Brain Trust developed any ideas?
California. That's it. That's where we're going.
I'll settle for a hamburger.
That's where all the dough and show business is anyway. There's nothing left but pictures.
You ought to be in pictures.
I wonder where we could borrow some money.
Don't do that. The cops are looking for us now from the last time.
I'm going to take a walk. Maybe I'll get an idea.
Wait a minute. You think it's safe to make a personal appearance tour?
I'll sneak through every back alley from here to the Battery. The Pacific Coast needs us. California, here I come.
What are you going to do with a guy like that?
I think I'll go back and take a cold shower.
See, stocks and things. Of course, if I sell them now, it means taking a loss. We got this contract starting next week, and this is just to tide me over.
Things are too tight, Charlie. I haven't got it.
Listen, Jim, I'm in a jam, and I need the dough to get out of town. I haven't got a dime. If you don't let me have it, I don't know what I'm going
to
do.
Oh, you wanted me to give you 200 bucks, and then you were going to blow town.
You'll get it back.
No dice. You were still walking the wire. I could tell you where you could get it, though.
Huh?
Oh, I wouldn't tell you. It's too risky. Either in the wire act on the show that'll touch it.
Listen, for 200 bucks, I'll walk the Atlantic cable. Now you're gonna tell me you're out. You hear? Let's have it.
Okay, okay. Now, wait a minute.
What's the lowdown?
Well, there's a guy that's in the beer business, and he thought up a stunt.
Are you sure this is all right?
They couldn't find a law to make Kelly and his bride get down off the flagpole, could they?
I know, but this is different. It's over a public highway.
It's in the bag, I tell you. I made a deal with the police department that if they'd rope off the side street with this stunt, we'd make the Kellys get down off the pole and it was over.
I don't know.
Well, I do. I've been selling homemade wild men for 20 years. Beer's essential. Why, there's $1 million worth of publicity in it. Every newsreel in the country's out there.
How about it?
Let's have the 200.
What if something happens to him?
Well, you've got your publicity anyway.
Oh, just a pal, aren't you?
You! Found this little outfit in there. You mind?
Very smart, too. We'll make it again.
Scotty, did you ever hear the old bromide? He travels fastest who travels alone.
So what?
Oh, why don't you forget about Charlie and me? You've got it, and on your own you can make it.
You're not serious, are you?
I am.
But you've been around me for a year. You ought to know me better than that.
I'm talking to you for your own good.
But Charlie and I have been together for 10 years. We broke in together, watering elephants and running errands. We fought our way through circuses, carnival shows, saloons, and what have you. Do you think I'd split up with him now? For anything in the world. It'd be like cutting my arm off. He's just like my own brother.
Where do I fit in?
Oh, you know what Charlie thinks about you. He's been walking around in a dream since the first day he saw you.
Did you ever like anybody very much? Like you say Charlie does me?
Oh, I don't think so. I'm sort of a catch-as-catch-can guy. Maybe I just haven't met the right one.
No, I guess you haven't.
Well, how about something to eat?
That would be a novelty.
Hey, you! Will you keep quiet or will I have to call the police?
Be quiet yourself. What do I ask? Nothing but the way I shall find the Mrs. Captain. Do I ask you to come with me? No!
I don't like you.
Go back into your kitchen. Now, all I ask you from you is the Witch of Underly, the Witch of Dawn. Oh, what kind of place is this? These people look like a rabbit.
Chilevi.
God, my boy. It's a fucking man.
Hey, you look pretty good, too, huh?
And the kids, they bumped into Gomestar.
Look around.
Oh, that's swell.
Let me know, yes, I'll see him, but I know him just the same. Oh, you're crazy. Then let us. Scott, the police, where is your room?
One more floor off, the first door to the right. Come on, we go now.
Mr. Scotty.
Go ahead, I'll be right up. Go ahead.
Now, listen, Mr. Scotty, I gave you 3 days, but I'll have no maniac in my house.
Siamo arrivati. Siete uniti in matrimonio, ma molto piacere. Ma why you not write to me you have a wife? Huh?
I haven't anyone.
Oh, I see.
Come here. This is Toby, one of my partners. This is Cellini.
How do you do?
It is my pleasure.
Now, will you tell me what brought you here?
Scott, you yourself in this last letter, you said, Cellini, I wish you were here. Well, I am here. In any way, I always want to see America. Such marvelous country. So big. People have so much money. But if you make so much money, why do you live here?
Well, we're not here very much.
Oh, I see. Well, now I gotta take a bath. Then I take a sleep, eh? Your supper time, you wake me up, eh? I'd be so hungry.
Would you mind telling me what just went through there?
I told you about Cellini a long time ago, don't you remember?
Oh, you mean the one who took you in when your folks died? What a merry little family we're getting to be. Now Father shows up.
We mustn't let him know how things are going. He thinks I'm at least a millionaire.
What are we going to do now?
Well, it looks like it's my turn for a cold shower. They're all set there.
Uh-huh. Well, good luck, kid.
When I get there, I'm dug under the stairs. They're not getting any close-ups of me. Right, fine. Hold it. You heard me. Get that cheese box out of the way. Here goes.
Police badge?
Uh-huh.
Listen, you go downstairs and tell nobody's home, you understand?
Huh?
Nobody's home.
Sure.
Must be one of those cops from Atlantic City. We gotta get out of here and see if we can't head Charlie off.
Should we take our things?
Yes, and get his suitcase too.
Well, what's going on here? Everybody crazy?
Makilla mafanna badrara. Sono shita tutta pazzoi.
You can wait if you want to, but there's nobody home.
Where's Mr. Sullivan's apartment?
There's nobody home.
Come on, hurry up.
Well, what's all this crazy business? Pretty soon I go crazy, too.
Can't stop to explain. Now we gotta move fast. Come on, down the fire escape.
Not that way. This way.
This way? What's the matter with this way?
Maybe it's Charlie.
I hope so.
Hello? Oh, Scotty, I just borrowed $200. Yeah, do you think it's safe for me to come back to the apartment?
No, no, there's a dick downstairs waiting for you. Yes? All right, we'll meet you at the bus station.
Scotty, what's a dick? Oh,
nothing like a banana. That's so good for you. You like some?
What? Why you not take a toppy away from me, huh?
Hmm? What are you talking about?
Well, you know what I'm talking about.
For the last time, Chalini, Toby is Charlie's girl. She's just a friend of mine, that's all.
But why not ask her? Maybe she has a different idea about that.
Let's talk about something else, huh?
Where goes New Mexico? Bet you never thought we'd get this far. Won't be long now. California. California. There's a place. We'll make a pile of dough and settle down. Then maybe later on we'll buy a great big house up on top of a hill. You ever think you'd settle down?
Hmm? Ever been talking to myself?
What? Did you say something?
Ooh, just a small muttering in my beard, I guess.
I'm sorry. I was thinking about something.
Hey, you've been doing a lot of that lately.
All right, what did you say?
Let it go.
Say, are you sure I don't know you from somewhere?
Listen, you've asked me that once every 10 miles ever since we've started. I'm positive I've never seen you before, and I don't care if I never see you again.
Can't you do something about them?
Hey, Chalini.
Time for lunch?
No, no. Go back to sleep. How are we doing?
Not so good.
What have you done with
him? He eats more than all of us put together.
It's too late to worry now.
We'll soon be in Santa Fe.
And what of it?
Well, can I have a dollar?
I gave you one yesterday.
I know, but I need another one badly.
Now, this will be the last until we get there.
Thank you. Entering Santa Fe, folks. You'll find the lunch room to the left. 1 hour for lunch.
Yes, sir.
I'll take this.
That'll be 79 cents.
I only paid 71 for it in Amarillo.
Do you want it or not?
Sure, I want it.
Pack a lucky face. Hello, Dan.
Oh, hello.
Buying a little something for the trip?
Yeah.
I don't blame you. It gets pretty dull.
We saw you on the bus.
Uh-huh. I saw you, too. You were with that pretty girl.
We thought as long as we're going to be together, we might as well get acquainted.
That's right.
Yeah, my name's Scotty.
My name's Joe.
Joe, meet Charlie.
Pleased to meet you, Charlie.
How do you do, Joe?
Well, you see, Joe's my real name, but all my friends call me Egghead.
Well, 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 Egghead.
Do you mind if we call you that? It's more informal, you know.
Oh, sure, go right ahead.
Shall we, go sit down someplace?
Huh?
Good idea.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
Here you are, Egghead, old boy. Sit down, make yourself comfortable.
Thanks.
Where are you from, Iggy?
Hollywood.
That's a charming lady sitting next to you.
Huh?
I mean on the bus.
Oh, her. Well, that's Madame Rose. She tells fortunes. We're just coming back from the World's Fair.
How did they ever let you get away?
Huh?
Nothing. I suppose she's a relative of yours.
My aunt.
Oh, she's your aunt.
Well, not exactly my aunt.
Not exactly?
No, I just travel with her.
Iggy, old son, have another little nip.
Well, thanks.
You don't buy much of a time, do you?
Well, she don't give me enough money. That's why I can't give you fellas any, because this is the last till I get home.
But she has quite a bit of money, hasn't she?
It must be great to have someone take you around like this. I bet you don't have to worry about a thing, do you?
Hmm. That's all I do is worry. That's why I drink, because I need
courage. Aggie, don't tell us you really worry.
Mm-hmm.
What about?
Well, I'm going to tell you fellas something, because you've been nice to me. Well, don't get scared, because there ain't no bullets in it. I threw them away a long time ago, because I was scared.
But what do you do with that?
I'm her bodyguard.
Well, how about something to eat?
You go ahead. I'll be right with you.
I saw you in a newsreel.
Will you be quiet and go away?
You're the fellow that walked wild across the street 10 stories up. Gee, I am glad to meet you.
Why did you have to be born?
The greatest thing I ever saw.
Will you please go away?
Wait a minute. This sounds very interesting. I'd like to hear more about it.
Why, you're his friends, ain't you? You don't mean to tell me that you don't know.
Why, you...
All right, Sullivan, what's this all about?
Oh, come on. Let's take a walk.
Ouch!
It was nothing to it as long as it didn't look down. I may believe it was only 2 feet off the ground. It was a cinch.
Oh, a cinch, huh? That's how you got the money. You should have known that nobody would lend you $200. I don't know whether to kiss you or slug you.
Oh, Charlie, you might have been killed.
Now, what do I care? I'm being paid with interest right this minute.
How do you do, Mr. Palopoulos? You don't remember me. I'm Charlie Sullivan. I worked for you once.
Did you?
Uh-huh. Scotty Brown and Sullivan. We're on our way to the coast. I'd like to talk to you about some booking.
I don't talk to you about anything.
Now, Mr. Palopoulos, we got a swell act.
I don't care if you're doing a production of Abe's Irish Road. Go away.
Go away? That's the great Palopoulos he's talking to. He owns about 10 theaters on the coast.
A great pal of yours, isn't it?
Skip it. You gotta do something. We can use this guy to get a bankroll that'll carry us till we crash pictures. There's a piano here, and you're gonna sing a song.
I am not.
You gotta do it. If he goes for it, our troubles are over.
With all these tourists here, not in your life.
They'll love it. Come on, this is our break. We can't miss it.
We can't do that.
Go ahead. What do we care about them? Maybe the gag will work.
That's right. Listen to reason.
I'll listen, but it's not reason.
Supposed to be exquisite. I wonder, is it wild or tame? What is the proper way to treat it? How can you beat that funny game? Ever since the world began, it's been puzzling every man. Love's a lot of trouble, and yet a blessing from above. You must learn each rule, you're going to school. when you're in love. Love will gently pet you and then upset you with a shove. Whether big or small, you learn how to crawl when you're in love. Love's a trail you're always traveling, but you don't know where you're bound. Love's a game you keep unraveling. It's a merry, merry-go-round. Love is bound to hit you, so make it fit you like a glove. You're a beggar alone, but a king on a throne when you're in love.
Remember,
if they start
throwing things, it's all your fault.
Very nice.
I
knew you'd like it, Mr. Lollipop.
A lawful is. Love's a lot of trouble, and yet a blessing from above. You must learn it, groom. You're going to...
You like them too, eh?
I noticed you on the bus, and I thought I'd try one.
I saw you too.
No good.
Nothing in the world will like a banana.
I think I'll go and get another banana flower. Would you like one too?
Well, if you like. Thank you.
Love's a train you're always traveling, but you don't know where you're bound. Love's a game you keep unraveling. It's a merry, merry-go-round. Love is bound.
She's okay. Laughing boy.
Too much spaghetti gives you one great big tummy ache.
Now it's bound to hit you.
That's what I've been thinking of.
You're a king on a throne.
I wish I was home.
When you're in love.
Love's a train you're always traveling.
What's the matter, Mr. Monopolis? Is that class or not?
Very good.
She's better than him for my dough.
It's a merry, merry, merry go round. Oh, love is bound to hit you.
So make it fit you like a glove.
You're a beggar alone, but a king on a throne. When you're in love.
I certainly would, if I hadn't just gone to New York and sold all my theaters.
What? All aboard!
Opera for you.
I should adore it.
Hey, what's he doing up there?
Well, I should think that'd be a great relief for you.
orange jelly.
Latte di pranzo è questo, latte e biscotti.
Hello, everybody.
Guess what's happened? I found us a job. We eat.
Bravo, bravo. You hear what he said? We eat the food.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. Sit down. Did you say a job?
I did.
Oh, I don't believe it.
Tell him, quick.
Well, it isn't much of a job.
Never mind about that. They pay money for it.
A few bucks a week and dinner for four every night.
Models. Now I'm gonna tell La Mama Rosa what I think of her.
Oh, no, you don't.
What's the matter? We got the job, but we make money. I'm gonna tell.
Listen, when I said a few bucks, I meant it. We won't get enough cash to pay rent on the doghouse.
Anyhow, it isn't set yet.
Oh, I know there was a catch to it.
A little dump out here that calls itself a roadhouse. Tonight's a tryout.
What if we miss?
Win, lose, or draw, we get fed tonight. That's the contract.
Oh, I dance all night long on my hands for one little steak.
Sure, that's a fine. But what about me and the fortune teller?
Keep right on going the way you are.
Oh, no, no more.
Cellini, you've got to, for all of us. As long as your masculine appeal holds out, we've at least got a place to sleep.
No, 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 no.
Yes, yes, yes.
No, 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 no.
Yes, 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 yes.
Me, Cellini, the great artist? What do you want to make out of me? A gigolo?
What's the matter? You liked her all right at first.
That's right. But then I didn't know she was crazy. All the time she look into that piece of glass. But as soon as she drive me crazy, too. I tell you, I no do no more. No, no, no more.
Oh, Cellini.
Please, let me go.
He's in here, Madame Rose.
Let me go.
Good afternoon, madam.
Blessings, my children. Come, Cellini. I'm ready for our walk.
No.
Why, Cellini, what's the trouble? Not a thing, Madame Rose. He's ready for his walk.
Madame, I am ready.
Come, Cellini. We shall go and commune with nature. Listen to the whisper of the breeze. And I shall teach you the language of the flowers.
Greater love hath no man than to do that for his friend.
Once on a boat in a very heavy fog.
Miss LaRue. This is a pleasure, Mr. Babcock.
Shh.
Quiet. Oh, I'm sorry. Excuse it, please.
Remember, you don't know me. You never saw either one of us before.
Why, of course not.
This way, please.
Anybody near us.
What a terrible dump.
Now, dear, don't stop that, sweetheart, please. You know why we have to come to these hideouts.
I'm getting sick and tired of these checker tablecloths. This is the last time.
Dearie, have a heart.
You might as well go to some decent place. You aren't fooling anybody in town.
Will you look at that?
I am.
All right. Now you see.
Wait a minute. We're just going to leave.
You heard me. Sing first, Benny.
Listen.
Sing.
Come on, Toby, let's get it over with.
Remind me to kill that guy someday.
This bump heads with me trying to be first.
$30 a week. What do you think of that, huh?
Great stuff.
Well, all right. Now you can eat. Say, I'm a pretty nice fella to do so much for you, no? Huh?
I'm a pretty nice fella to do so much for you, no, huh? The big ape.
Oh, an ape in these, huh? You do imitations for me. You make jokes with me. You call me a big ape, huh?
Listen, mister, I'm sorry.
Nothing doing. Get out. All of you.
Not before I eat.
And no eating. Come on, get out.
You hear? Wait a minute. Who do you think you're shoving? What's the matter with
you? Turn it off. Get away. Get
away. Wait a minute. What's going on here?
Oh, excuse it, please, Mr. Babcock.
Quiet. Go back in the kitchen where you belong. I want to talk to these people.
What did he say, Mr. Babcock?
You know who I am?
Of the International Pictures?
Yeah.
Mr. Babcock, everybody knows.
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. I'm here with my secretary and her sister. Strictly business.
Why, of course.
Young man, come to my office tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock. I'll have a job for you. Here's my card. Did I give you two? Oh, no, it's quite all right. Oh, what was that song you sang?
Well, I wrote it.
Good. I want that in my picture. I'll talk to you tomorrow morning about that, too.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Yeah, let's.
I'm sorry. I didn't know you knew Mr. Babcock.
Open the door.
Go ahead. Yes, of course, yes.
Say, will
What do we do now?
Simplest thing in the world. Borrow $5 from Anna Rose and go eat.
Cellini, go get it.
Me? No. I am not hungry. No. Nice follow. Thank you very much. Tomorrow we get the job. Just for tonight that we have enough money.
Dear boy, don't you know that all you have to do is to ask me?
Oh, my sure. Well, I go now.
Cellini, stay a little while. I want to talk to you.
All right, to talk, but to please, not touch.
Oh, Cellini, you're so cold. Don't you like me?
Why, sure. It's because I am just nervous.
Oh, well, then relax, little one. Cellini, do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to pull aside the veil and look into our future together.
Please, not again. I cannot stand it.
Cellini, be quiet.
No, I gotta go.
Sit still. Ah, it's coming.
I'm going.
I said be quiet. It's becoming clearer. I can see us now. We're two happy lovers, babes in the woods, strolling along the lane.
How beautiful.
Now we come to a rustic bridge. We stand by the railing side by side, looking down into the sparkling stream as it sings its way over each little pebble on its way down to the sea.
I'm getting thirsty.
Now we turn to each other. You take my hand. Now we're talking.
What do we say?
You're telling me that I'm beautiful, as fair as the summer skies, as lovely as the morning dew on a rose, as tender as the first blush of dawn.
But what you said back to me?
I tell you that I too love you, that we were destined for each other, that we were born for one purpose, just to be together forever and ever. Our feet must tread the same path, the rose-covered path of the rainbow. It's destiny, it's kismet, it's our life together, it's fate, it's love, it's beautiful.
Donna mia, serpent!
Cellini, come back here.
My!
Yes, I figured you did.
And you and me.
Who were you looking at when you said that?
She was looking at you, of course.
It's quite all right, darling. It's all coming to you. You simply walked away with the army.
I never thought I'd live to see the day.
What?
When that girl says that anybody else in one of her pictures is any good, she's either being nasty or it's love.
And it doesn't look as if she's being very nasty.
Well, that's pictures for you. She runs after him, and now instead of firing him, I've got to make a star out of him.
Oh, I thought you and Mr. Rue had just a business agreement.
Sure, just business. You don't think for one moment that...
Oh, no. I guess I've been kidding myself, too.
Wasn't that a riot?
May I help you, sir?
Thank you very much. I help myself, please.
celebrate the new picture, huh?
Sure, I'll celebrate, but I'm not happy.
What's the matter?
Charlie, it's Madame Rose. She likes Chalene.
Very charming couple, don't you think?
Yeah, but I'm scared. Suppose she marries him or something.
Oh, what a horrible thought. Now, why are you scared?
Well, if she does, then what's going to happen to me?
Iggy, let me put your mind at rest. You'll have no further trouble with Chalene.
You can fix it?
Sure, it's all a matter of business. Look, Madame Rose likes Chalene, so we get a bungalow. But now that we're big shots, we got all this. See?
Oh!
So now you're all set, huh?
Let's have another drink.
You know, Iggy, I'm not happy either.
No, what's the matter?
You know, Toby,
mm-hmm.
She's my girl.
I thought that she was Scotty's girl.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm afraid of. I'm beginning to think so myself.
Well, I just thought I didn't know.
Yeah, I know. You thought if she liked one of us, it must be him. I know.
Yeah, but she's awful cute.
You're telling me. I want to marry her. Well, look, Iggy, how are you going to marry a girl that's in love with somebody else?
How do you know she is?
I know. I just got a hunch.
Oh, I know. You're in love.
Oh, it's terrific. What am I going to do?
I got an idea. Suppose I talk to her.
No.
Well, suppose you talk to her.
No, I might find out I was right, Iggy.
Shh! What a sound.
Who is it?
That's what I've been wondering for a long time. Come on, we'll go find out. Quiet now.
Now then, who are you?
Hey, his mouth's so full of grass, they can't talk.
All right, we turn him over.
Hey, you know, I like him better than the other way.
No, wait a minute. Who are you?
I'm a detective.
I knew it. You've been following me, haven't you?
Yeah.
Well, what have you been waiting for? Why didn't you arrest me?
What for? I can't arrest anybody. I'm a private detective.
Well, what in the name of heaven you been following me around for?
Your ex-wife pays me to follow you and let her know when you go to work.
Well, I'll be here. She's just being mean, that's all. She's got more money than I'll ever see anyway. Why, it costs her more to keep you on the road than she'll ever get out of me.
Yeah, I know that. I don't like her either.
You know, we may be able to talk this over. What's your name, little man?
Hildebrand. And don't call me Hildy.
Oh, no, I let him call me Egghead.
All right, Hildy. We may be able to talk this over.
I haven't had a chance to congratulate you tonight. I'd like to.
Sure, thanks.
I thought you were wonderful.
Yeah, I was a bit surprised myself the way things went.
You're kidding, aren't you, Scotty?
About what?
You're not really letting all this throw you, are you?
I don't know what you're talking about. What's throwing me?
All the sudden thing that's happened?
Well, I don't say anything sudden about it. I've worked all my life for it, haven't I?
So the town's really got you. I've never believed it.
Oh, forget it, Whit.
You and I used to be friends.
What's that got to do with anything?
I know you've been acting funny lately, but I thought it was just because you were busy.
Oh, stop it, Whit.
But you really believe all this. You've lost your head. The town's got you. You've gone Hollywood.
Listen, you bother me. I brought us up from being hungry to this. What more do you want? Now look, be a good little girl and run along and find Charlie. There are quite a few people in here that want to see me.
Oh, there you are. Come on, darling. They all want us to do a number.
You're like a lover's dream in the spring.
Told you a long time ago.
I should have made it my business to find out.
I was afraid it would ruin everything for the three of us.
Well, how could that happen?
He'd never let anything come between you two.
Well, don't you think I could take it any better than that?
Oh, there's no use talking about it anyway. That's that, and we'll call it a day.
Well, stop being silly.
It's not silly. I couldn't stay here now.
Well, you're out of your mind. Now, listen. I, Charlie Sullivan, alone and unaided, positively guarantee to fix everything for you.
Charlie, you won't. Promise me.
Oh, what?
Say a word about this to anyone, please. I couldn't stand it. Promise me.
All right. I promise.
I'm sorry. Honest.
Okay.
I love to hear you say it.
Too beautiful for words. You're like a sweet refrain that will play. Strain at the angels' prayer.
If I could only play it.
Too beautiful for words. You are everything I've ever tried to picture.
Oh, really, you're wonderful and sweet.
You're a bundle full of love. Gorgeous mixture.
And you know how to start at something in my heart.
Oh, you bring an inspiration to sing a song that can never be heard. You're just a lovely.
What you brought me all the way up here for?
I'm telling you, now you're going in there and talk to her or else.
As a manager, you're tremendous. But you're forgetting there's a redhead downstairs and you're wasting a lot of my time.
Listen, Sonny boy, we've been together a long time. We haven't had any trouble. Well, I don't want any out of you now. Don't make me spill over the edges about this, will you?
Exactly what's your angle?
She's not for me, it's you. And she's going to get what she wants if I have to knock you over the head and chase all the redheads out of Hollywood to get it.
Then run along and have another nip. Fever dies down, you'll be all right.
I'm telling you what she just told me. She's probably in there packing right now. What are you gonna do? Let her go while you clown around with somebody that isn't worth the tiniest part of her?
Are you sure you know what you're doing?
I was never sure.
You're quite a fella. That's what I always told you, haven't I? The funny part is you've been right about it.
Oh, now go on in there, will you? Go on, go on.
He told you, didn't he?
Come in.
No, go away.
You don't suppose there have been any of the things I've been doing, do you?
No. Oh, she's meaning. Oh, you naughty boy. You've been hiding. You just wanted to make me find you, didn't you?
No, it is not so, madame. I hide here away from everybody because I am suffering.
Suffering? Oh, poor little one, tell me.
It isn't because you are so beautiful. Oh. It isn't because you are so lovely. Oh. Your eyes, your hair, everything about you.
My Cellini.
But I am no good.
What?
I have lied to you.
What do you mean?
In Italy, I have a wife and a 7 kids.
What?
But you are so beautiful, I cannot tell you. But now I must.
You imposter. You heartbreaker, you. You snake in the grass. Take it, my crystal. Oh! Aiken, come on!
Well, that's that.
Now I'll have something to eat.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have quiet, please? This party tonight is not only in celebration of the new picture, it's a double celebration. And I've been allowed the signal honor of announcing the other reason. It gives me great pleasure and happiness to announce the engagement of Mr. Paul Scotty to Miss Toby Brown.
Well, little man?